Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to install or update your Intel HD graphics drivers on Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, to get started with Intel, go to Google and then do a search for Intel HD graphics. The first webpage should be from Intel, which says support for Intel graphics. Go ahead and click on that. And then on this next page, you'll see this tool that says, let us identify your products and update your drivers. So you can go ahead and click on this button to get started. And then on this next page, you'll need to download the Intel driver and support assistant tool. So go ahead and click on download now. It's going to start the download. Click on it to open the file. And then once you get to this installation, just agree to the terms, then click on install. If you want to join the improvement program, click on accept. Otherwise, just click on decline, which is what I'm going to do here. And then it's going to install this Intel driver and support assistant tool. And this is going to help you identify which Intel drivers you need on your system. And that includes the graphics driver. Once the installation is complete, you can click on launch. And then you might be prompted to open a link. You can choose any one of these browsers. I'm just going to choose Google Chrome and then click on Always. And it should open a new page and it should tell you which drivers needs to be updated on your computer. Now, in most cases, you should be seeing a list of drivers that you can update here, and the graphics driver should be one of them. But in my case, it said there are no supported driver or software updates available for your system. Now, that's actually not correct. But what you can do from this page is you can click on the Devices and Drivers tab here on the left. And then you can click on the graphics to expand it. And basically the only thing that you're looking for here is what Intel HD graphics you have. So I've got Intel HD graphics 4000 for this computer. And with that in mind, I'm just going to scroll up on this website. And then where it says searchintel.com, I'm going to search and I'm going to type in Intel HD graphics 4000, and then one of the best matches is the Intel HD graphics 4000 driver. So I'm going to click on that. Now, if you scroll down on this list, you should have this support for Intel HD graphics for your Intel HD graphics. And if you scroll down on the next page, you should have an option to get a list of drivers for Intel HD graphics. And then once again, you can use method one to automatically detect your graphics. But if you scroll further down, you'll get a second method where you can identify the driver and install it manually. Now on this computer, I've got Windows 11 installed. So if you select your operating system here and you click on it, it's gonna expand the available drivers for that operating system. If I have a look at this list, I don't actually see my processor family listed here. And on this computer, I've got a third gen processor, and you can just verify that by right-clicking on the start button, then clicking on system. And then you'll see what processor you have here. This laptop's got an Intel Core i5-3, and that means it's a third gen processor. So if this was a 5, for example, it would mean that I have a fifth gen processor, but I've got a third gen. Now, with that in mind, because I don't see it listed here in the Windows 11 drop-down menu, I'm just gonna close this and then click on Windows 10. And if I have a look at the processor families listed here, if I scroll down, I'll find the third gen Intel Core processors with Intel HD graphics 4000, and that's exactly what I have. So I'm going to download this driver, and you can click on the left here to be taken to the webpage where you can download it. And then you can also choose an older version from this drop-down menu if you want, but I'm going to download the latest driver. So I'll select that, and then in the available downloads, I'm going to download the driver for 64-bit version of Windows, but there is also a 32-bit version. But I have 64-bit installed, so I'll go ahead and download the 64-bit version of this driver, and then it's going to start the download. And once it's finished, you can just click on the file to open it. It's going to launch the Intel graphics driver setup wizard. You can leave these settings on default and then click on next, click on yes, then click on next again, and then it's going to start installing the latest version of the Intel HD graphics driver for your computer. But once it's finished, this is the screen that you'll see, and then you can click on next. And then you'll also be prompted to restart your computer. You can go ahead and click on finish to do that, so you can restart your computer. And then once your computer has finished starting up, if you right click on the start button and then click on device manager, In the device manager, if you expand the display adapters, you should see that the Intel HD graphics is installed, and it shouldn't have any yellow triangles or exclamation marks next to it. It should look like you're seeing here now. And you can also right click on it, then click on properties, and then click on driver, and then you'll also see the driver version that you have installed for this particular GPU. So this is the latest driver that we downloaded from Intel's webpage and manually installed to the computer. So I hope this guide's been useful. If you have any questions or thoughts on the video, please leave a comment down below, and I'll talk to you guys soon.